Guests, elders, brothers, youngsters. Nowadays, in our community, especially in the European states, it has become a fashion to be, to prove yourself to be academic. And it has become a style to boast that I follow Bukhari, I follow Muslim, and Hanafis, they are just bunch of Ahlul Rai. They can't find any hadith. And they go with logic, and the way they approach the young generation of our age and our elders from back home when they come here and they've studied their religion according to their understanding, they find it very hard to handle these young people, boys and girls, especially those in the universities. And they think, with their little knowledge, that what we do, sometimes they would claim, and they dare claim, that this taqleed is shirk. Na'uzu billah. They should understand, before they say something like that, what it means to claim that it is shirk, or it is blind following, or it is, they would say, I am a Muhammadi, I'm not Hanafi, I'm not Shafi, I'm not Maliki, I'm not Hanbali, I am Muhammadi, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam should be followed. So what they are trying to do, that 99% of the Muslim Ummah for the last 14 and a half centuries, they have been Muqallids. And they, according to these people, have been acting with shirk. Even Imam Bukhari, he did not claim to be a mujtahid, a mutlaq. Even Imam Bukhari was a muqallid. Imam Muslim was a muqallid. Imam Abu Dawud, Nasai, Ibn Majah, Tirmidhi. And even Imam Shafi would sometimes say, Amaltuhu taqlidan li fulan wa fulan. I have acted on this, doing taqleed of so and so and so. Now let's come to our subject. Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah, he was born in Iraq. And there is a book called Fiqhul Iraq. There is a book written by Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi, known as Tariq Baghdad. And to talk fairly on this matter, we ask those brothers who say and claim themselves Ahle Hadith or Salafi. In real matter, we, the Hanafis, should claim Salafis. Because Salafi means to follow the Salaf. Now, out of the four Imams, or the five Imams, the Imam of the Salafis, they claim Ibn Taymiyyah. So when was Ibn Taymiyyah born, or Ibn al-Qayyim? When was Imam Shafi or Malik or Ahmad ibn Hanbal was born? So according to the birth of the Imam, we follow the closest Imam to the Prophet. So we should say that Hanafis are the real Salafis. Now let's come to the claim Imam Abu Zahra, Sheikh Akbar, the Vice Chancellor of Al-Azhar University. He wrote a book on Imam Abu Hanifa, and he said that Imam Abu Hanifa had 70,000 hadiths preserved in his house. He had a special library for the hadiths. And then he says these 70,000 hadiths, in the time of Imam Bukhari, we will be calculated by 90% more. So in the time of Imam Bukhari, Imam Abu Hanifa's 70,000 will be calculated 700,000. Imam Abu Hanifa's knowledge of hadith is 700,000. And Imam Bukhari's hadith is 600,000. So Imam Abu Hanifa ke ulumul hadith mein Imam Bukhari se 1,00,000 hadith zyada hai. So no one should ever underestimate the knowledge of hadith by Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. The only difference between Imam Abu Hanifa and the other muhaddisun is that the faqih cannot be a faqih. A jurist cannot be a jurist unless he has the knowledge of hadith. But the profession of a jurist and a faqih and a muhaddith is two different things. Like when somebody does Dawra-e Hadith, they have to read Tafsir, they have to read Fiqh, they have to read Usulul Fiqh, they have to read Usulul Hadith, they have to read the Siha Sitta. But after they finish that, then they specialize in Tafsir, or Fiqh, or Tariq, or Lugha, or any other faculties of Islam. But before doing Dawra-e Hadith, every minimum knowledge has to go through that system. So not a single mujtahid in the world can be a mujtahid unless he knows that all the hadith of the world, living world, and unless he has knowledge of 80 faculties of deen. This is what Imam Anwar Shah Kashmiri rahimahullah said. And this is why people like Ibn Hajar Asqalani and the Ashab-e Siha Sitta, no one claimed, no one ever dared claim that they are Imam of a madhab. Why did Imam Bukhari did not create his own madhab? So every single muhaddis of their age, they were a muqallid. So Imam Abu Hanifa's students were the biggest teachers of Imam Bukhari. Abdullah ibn Mubarak is a Hanafi. Musannaf ibn Abi Shayba is a Hanafi. Musnad Abdul Razak is a Hanafi. All the muhaddisun after the time of Imam Abu Hanifa, they were the students of Imam Abu Hanifa. Even Imam Malik was a student of Imam Abu Hanifa. Imam Malik also a student of Imam Abu Yusuf. Imam Malik said, I have gained knowledge and fiqh from Abu Yusuf, and Abu Yusuf gained hadith from me. Imam Shafi was the student of Imam Abu Yusuf and Imam Muhammad. And Imam Shafi is the Imam of Ahlul Athar, Ahlul Muhaddisin, Ahlul Hadith. He said, the whole world are the children of Imam Abu Hanifa in fiqh. An-nasu iyalun ala fiqhi Abi Hanifa. Man arada bil fiqhi fa'alayhi bi ashabi Abu Hanifa. One who wants to be a faqih, then it is an obligation on that person that he looks for the people and the students of Imam Abu Hanifa. So if we did not, and Imam Badruddin Aini rahimahullah wrote that Imam Tahawi had more knowledge of Islam other than hadith more than Imam Bukhari. You will find that in Amaniul Ahbar, the Shara written by Hazrat Ji Yusuf Rahmatullahi Alayhi of Tahawi. So praising Imam Tahawi, Badruddin Aini said, and he said, if you do not believe me, then look at the Tarajim of Tahawi and look at the Tarajim of Bukhari, and you will find what I'm trying to say is a real proof. Now, the first muhaddis in the history of Islam who has written the Shara of Hadith is a Hanafi, says Subhanallah. That is Imam Tahawi himself. Imam Tahawi was the first person in the history of Islam who started to write the Shara of Hadith. Imam Bukhari did not write a Shara on Hadith, not Ashabi Sitta. So the first person, and he was the Mujaddid of the second century. And one of the first person in the history of Islam to gather the Hadith and Takhrij of Fiqh was a Hanafi. Say Alhamdulillah. And the writer is Zaylai Rahimahullah, one who had wrote Nasbur Raya. And people say, Laula Zaylai Lama Ja'a Ibn Hadar Wama Dhaaba. If there was not Zaylai, then it would not have been possible for Ibn Hajar to come or go. Now, one of the greatest Shara of Hadith of Bukhari is Ibn Hajar. And Ibn Hajar Rahimahullah has taken his concept from a Hanafi scholar called Zaylai Rahimahullah. In Azhar University, in the Faculty of Hadith, they claim that Rahimallahu Ikhwanana min al-Hind, that our brothers of India, for the last 5 centuries, they have preserved the Sanad of Hadith. In Middle East, you don't have Siha Sitta read with the Sanad. You do PhD on Hadith, they will not read you like the one in Pakistan or in Deoband or Hindustan or Bangladesh. So for 5 centuries, the Hanafis were the savior of Hadith. So it is the Hanafis. Abdullah ibn Mubarak, he says, Allah has made me fortunate by 2 people. If these 2 people were not for me, then I would have been like any layman. And one of them is Imam Abu Hanifa Rahimahullah. And the other one is Sufyan Thawri. Sufyan Thawri says, Awwalu man sayyarani muhaddisan Abu Hanifa. The first person who had given me to chance to become a muhaddis is Imam Abu Hanifa. Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla and Yahya ibn Yahya, Yahya ibn Ma'in. These are the mountains of knowledge of Hadith. And if they find difficulty in understanding the Hadith, they will say, Nahnu sayadala wa antumul atibba. We only have the knowledge of Hadith, but we do not have the understanding of the Hadith. You, the fuqaha, are the people who understand. If anybody had any difficulty, Abdurrahman ibn Abi Layla was a person who used to be against Imam Abu Hanifa. But at night time, he would study the books of Imam Abu Hanifa. One of his students sneaked in and see he's doing that. Because when there is a difficulty in understanding a mas'ala, he will return back to the books of Imam Abu Hanifa. He said, "You, what are you doing? You seem to be talking against him. You're criticizing him." He goes, "Without this man, we are nothing. Without this Abu Hanifa, we are nothing." You see, the ulama says the muhaddisun is like the bodyguard of a court. You know, you have security guards in the court, because what is the duty of a security guard? To preserve and look after. This is the job of the muhaddisun. And what is the job of the judge? He's not the security guard. He just relies on the security guard. His job is to give judgment. Fuqaha are the judge. Muhaddisun is the security guard. You need the security guard for the safety of the witness and the clients and the barristers and the court. For Islam, we need the security guards of the Muhaddisun. Jazahumullahu ahsanul jaza. But to understand the deen, it was one of the greatest point of Muhaddisun in the second century. لا يجوز لطالب العلم أن يدرس في علوم الحديث إلا أن يكون له إماما في الفقه. It was not jais in the second century for a person to study hadith under any teacher unless he had an imam in fiqh. Because when you read the hadith without an imam, you will be misguided because there is so much contradiction. So it was Ibn Taymiyyah rahimahullah, he says, I am proud to be a Sufi from the tradition of Abdul Qadir Jilani. Between me and Abdul Qadir Jilani, there is only two sanad. And Ibn Taymiyyah's student and Khalifa in Tasawwuf is Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn Taymiyyah is the Sheikh and the Murid is Ibn al-Qayyim. Ibn al-Qayyim, if you want to know what he is, read his Madarij al-Salikin. It is full of Tasawwuf and Sufi. So we better understand not to go against this ulama. You see, one of the greatest muhaddis of the 10th century was Mullah Ali Qari. He was a Hanafi, he was a faqih, and he was a Sufi. One of the greatest muhaddis of India was Abdul Haq Dehlavi rahimahullah. And he is a Hanafi, he is a Sufi, he is a muhaddis. Then after them, Imam Shah Waliullah, Abdul Aziz Dehlavi, Shah Ishaq, then Shah Abdul Ghani, then Rashid Ahmad Gangohi, then you have Qasim Nanotvi, then you have Hussein Ahmad Madani, Sheikh al-Hind, Sheikh Zakaria rahimahullah. For the last 5 centuries, without a Hanafi scholar, you are nowhere in understanding the hadith. In Jami Azhar, they say that the two greatest encyclopedia of understanding hadith is Fathul Bari, and the second is Umdatul Qari. And my teacher used to say, Umdatul Qari is more better and more disciplined than Fathul Bari. And Fathul Bari is the muhaddis, one of the greatest muhaddis, even the teacher of Ibn Hajar. He is a Hanafi. One of the greatest shuruhat of Hidayah is Fathul Qadir. And he was the greatest muhaddis of his time, Kamaluddin Ibn al-Humam. He is given the status of Imam Tahawi in understanding fiqh. He is from the third status of Islam in Mujtahideen. And he was from the 8th century. And he was a big sheikh. Bahrul Rayiq is one of the greatest faqih kitab in tradition of hadith. So we are full of hadith. We, the Hanafis, we have the greatest hadith narration. So the last thing what I would like to say, never underestimate the Hanafis, never underestimate the Hanafi fiqh. Let me just finish with the last word. Sha'rani rahimahullah, Abdul Wahab Sha'rani rahimahullah, the fine that he's written in one of his books, that Allah has shown me in my kashf the 4 madhab and their length. And I have seen Fiqh Hanafi is the longest. And they say, and then Imam Malik, then Imam Shafi, then Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal. So Hanafi Fiqh is the greatest because they say that Mujaddid Mahdi al-Ma'ud, he will follow, his ijtihad will be same with Imam Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. So no one should underestimate the fiqh of Abu Hanifa rahimahullah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.